パーンパララーンパーンパララーンパララーン。 Man, the music in this game is pretty fantastic. Hey, internet, how's everything going? Not that you can answer back, this isn't live, this is pre-recorded. But how you doing? Yet again, I find myself trying to run a website all by myself. Skeleton crew once again. It's difficult. It's difficult when you're trying to start a website and you pretty much got the smallest crew in the fucking world. So, instead of putting up a half-assed content on the site, I'm going to just record something and put it up. We got some new hardware in today. We got an Elgato Game Capture HD 60, so we can start recording things at 60 frames per second and putting them up. So I thought the first test would be putting up a game that I love very, very much that also runs at 60 frames per second, Spelunky. Of course, if you're watching this right now as it goes up, you won't be seeing this at 60 frames per second because YouTube, which is where we host our videos, does not support 60 FPS just yet. That'll be coming later on, but they did say that videos uploaded during this time at 60 will then become 60 after the update. There's no need to re-upload the video, so hopefully, eventually, this video will be 60 frames per second when you're watching it. But yeah, we're testing out the new hardware. After I test it out, we'll also have an at a glance and show you a bunch of stuff about it. But what I the reason I wanted to test with Spelunky, because I actually haven't played Spelunky in a bit, since about a month or two, since I was in the hospital. So I thought it'd be cool to play it and watch me die. So the way I play Spelunky is that I usually play 5 rounds and then I stop. 5 rounds can mean I go for, you know, an hour, 2 hours. But, you know, 5 rounds can mean an hour or 15 minutes, depending on how good or bad I do. And since I'm not very good at Spelunky, I'm going to guess it's going to be somewhere around 30 minutes or so. This is the guy I use, the little clown cyan guy. He's my favorite. Let's just jump right in and play some Spelunky. I have beaten Spelunky before. I have gotten to Olmec. I've only beaten Olmec once, but I've gotten to him multiple times. And every time I've died in Olmec, it has been because I've been really fucking stupid and wasn't paying attention. But yeah, let's try this thing out. Let's see if I remember how to control things right. I usually play Spelunky on the Vita. Playing on the PS3 controller might screw me up a little bit more than normal, because I'm used to the Vita's really tight D-pad. I love the Vita D-pad, it's really great. It's probably not that much different. The PS3 has a pretty decent D-pad as well. The only gamepad that I don't like the D-pad on is the 360 controller. Granted, I haven't tried the Xbox One gamepad, but I hear that D-pad is much, much better. I'm gonna take this. I'm gonna take this and throw it. Oop. There we go. So I'm trying to just collect as much gold as I can. I try to go into the second area with at least, 10,000 gold. That's obviously not gonna happen this time, but let's hope that we can get some gold at the top of the next area soon. Or the reason I want to get 2,000 gold is because in case there's a bomb box at the shop. There's always a shop in... Fuck, I hate dark levels. There's always a shop in World 2-1-2. And I just want to make sure that I can buy something, but nothing here. Like, I kind of want that shotgun, but I can get a free shotgun later on if I get a zombie level. So I'm not gonna waste that. There's a bat. I'm gonna try and not die. Ooh, that could have ended real poorly. Luckily I had that that parachute. I think we're at the end of the level already. Fucking god damn it. I always run when I play Spelunky. It's probably something I shouldn't do. It's because for that exact reason where I couldn't see in front of me and I ran straight into a bat and lost the health. And I haven't found any damsels to restore my health, so that's a bummer. Let's just keep going. I am not going to do the daily challenge because no one on my PSN friends list plays Spelunky. In fact, I actually don't have many people on my PSN friends list at all. I'm not much of a one to play online with friends That might change when I get Destiny, even though Destiny seems like it's a lukewarm kind of thing. But I'll play it eventually. I wanted to try to get it early for the site, but that couldn't happen. So now I'll just play it on my own. Probably not this year, maybe early next year. I'm trying to do it this year so I can talk about it for the end of the year, a feature that I have planned for the site for the best games, best music, and best movies of the year. But currently we don't have a PS4, so it's gonna be difficult. I'm trying to get a PS4 in the studio, in the office, whatever you want to call it. Hopefully in November or something. But that'll also serve difficult because PS4s cost money. And eventually we want to get an Xbox One in here too, so we can cover games like, you know, like D4. We're not going to cover D4. It's by the time we get an Xbox One, it'll be too late. But we want to cover, you know, like, you know, eventually the next Halo game and, you know, the bigger games. Actually, I really want to cover Quantum Break. That game actually looks pretty cool. It looks like a, you know, it looked cooler before they actually showed some gameplay of it, because the gameplay kind of shows it's just a third-person shooter. But the whole time-bending mechanics still interest me enough that I kind of want to check that game out. And I'm kind of excited for it. Let's see if we find the key somewhere. I've lost a lot of health, and I haven't noticed. Oh boy. It's... Oh fuck, Nope, I'm gonna die. I am not paying attention. No, that's a lie. I'm paying a lot of attention. I am just not playing very well. I just try to use an excuse. Okay, well, there's fucking that. God damn it. Sorry for that extended silence. We had some small audio problems while we were playing with the microphone. It's new hardware, guys. That's why we're testing this, to make sure it works seamlessly. Not fuck. Anyway, as I was saying, we want this to work seamlessly, so that's why we're testing it. That'll be all solved once we do proper recordings for At a Glances and other videos that we do video game coverage on. But for now, we'll have to deal with that. I'm not gonna... there's not really much I can do, you know, in editing to fix that. There's literally no audio recorded for that section. But, you know, we'll make do. I am trying not to die. Bat. Stupid bats. Alright. I want that damsel. Oh, I can't believe I lost 2 health already on the first... Usually, sometimes when I lose that much health on the first goddamn level, I just commit suicide sometimes. But I'm not gonna do that here, because that's not really any fun. Wanna see how far I can actually go in my 5 tries. Okay. I like to think I'm a little better at Spelunky than you actually see me playing right now, because I just haven't played in a while. But that very well might not be true. But I'm gonna say it is, because you guys on the internet cannot prove it, because I have not played Spelunky That's a lie. I was gonna say I had not played Spelunky on the internet before, but I have. There's a recorded stream of me playing Spelunky somewhere on Twitch. And that's equally as bad, maybe even worse. So you guys can prove me wrong if I said that. Okay. Let's get some of this money. Hopefully there's something worth buying at the shop. Wherever the shop is, it should be around here somewhere. There it is. I'll take that. Let's see what's on the other side of this level here. Just that shrine and that spider. So we're gonna leave. Skip, 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 skip. More spiders. I'll take this just for now to trigger that down there. Oh, it's a snake pit. I want that. I definitely want that. I want you. Okay. There's always a matic there, so I'm gonna break that, get the matic. I'm gonna go here first because it looks like there's some cool stuff here, but I'm pretty sure, yeah, the exit's on the other side, as I expected, just from like the formations of the rocks and stuff. I can't get that up there. I don't want to deal with that spider, so I'm just gonna go over here. That's already been activated, I think, because I see the thing there. So let's go up here. Let's get you. The spider there. Get the matic back. I'm gonna go down here and get this gold, and I'm gonna go. And we're back up to 4 health, too, thanks to that lady, that pretty lady that we saved. In the PC and PS3 versions of the game, possibly the 360 version too, I'm not entirely sure, you can actually get a secret damsel, and that's the sloth. I've actually used it before. It's gone, but it's activated by going into the settings. And then I believe you click like a bunch of times until it shows up, but I'm not gonna do that because it takes too much time. So I think it's like 100 times or something like that. I can't remember the exact amount of times, but yeah, I did it and it totally works. And you get a little sloth. So many spiders. Okay, this is really unfortunate. Gonna ignore all those spiders and run away. What can we get here? I'm gonna get the spike boots. The glove. No, I'm not gonna get the glove right now. I like the glove though. It's a cool item. It makes everything you throw go directly straight, which is useful in times like this, where there's like a giant hallway like that. But then again, it would have gone straight anyway because it's a hallway. Let's get this gold. Oh, there's a spider. A bat there. So never mind. I'm just gonna go to the jungle. The jungle is the area that I hate the most. Like I think I hate it even more than I hate the temple. And I fucking hate the temple. Shit, that's not what I wanted to do. There we go. Get some of these emeralds. But yeah, like, the jungle's the fucking worst, in my opinion. Because at least in a temple, if I had the matic, I can just kinda... dig my way through the temple. Alright, I gotta... Oh no! Alright, stupid monkey. Oh, that landed right in the fucking... right in the spikes. Oh no, stop, you're gonna die. Cause you're gonna walk right into that tiki trap, so.
I'll save you, damsel.
The other thing you can do with the damsels is you can sacrifice them by putting them in the altars. Like, all this stuff that I'm saying is all things that everyone knows by now, I'm sure, because Spelunky has been out for years and years and years and years. But I still play it a lot because it's such a fun game. It's not like a bunch of other seemingly difficult games where they're just difficult because they suck and they're hard because, you know, sometimes you feel like they control wrong or they're just unfairly hard. Spelunky is difficult because it's built really well. Like, I missed that completely. I didn't mean to do any of that. But yeah, like, the controls feel really tight. Everything that you do feels like you actually did it on purpose, never by mistake. For the most part, every now and then, sometimes I feel like the game gypped me. But that happens very rarely. See? So you saw that? Pro moves right there. But yeah, everything's just really tight and responsive. And, you know, the game, whenever you die, you feel like it's your own fault, not because the game cheated you. Again, for the most part, there are some times where I feel like the hitbox was off by a little bit and that shouldn't, something like an arrow shouldn't have hit me or something. Fuck. God. That was my fault. That was my fault for not timing that right. Alright, next game. We'll play until I get 2060 deaths, and right now I'm at 2057, if I remember that right. Alright, so there's a box up there that I want to get. Fuck, I didn't want that to be there. But whatever. Oh, the glove. That's nice. Okay. Spiderwebs. I need something else to pick up and be able to throw. I always like to carry something. Because that way, if I ever have to like trigger a spike trap, I can do that by just dropping whatever I'm carrying. Oh no! The damsel counts too, by the way. I very often use my damsel as a as bait or as an object to just trigger traps. Gold. I said the jungle was my least favorite level, the one I hated the most, and I think my favorite level is that is between the mines, because it's the first one, and the ice caves. I actually really like the ice caves too. Ooh, that was a close one actually. The ice caves actually can be super, super easy if you have like a jetpack or even the cape, and the compass. If you have a combination of those items, like some combination of those items, compass and jetpack or compass and cape, you can pretty much just breeze through the caves, the ice caves. The mines here though, even for a level one, they can be kind of brutal sometimes. That gold. Oh god, no! I thought that spider was gonna come down all the way and hit me. I took the risk, and it paid off this one time. It doesn't always pay off to risk. In fact, it almost never pays off to take a risk in Spelunky. It's much better to play it safe. Oh, I'm gonna throw that up. Oh well, I can do this now. That was too high. Right, I'm gonna try not to trigger it then. Oh no! No! Okay. Come here. Boom. Oh, I'm gonna blow that up. Oh, the spiderweb! Ah. want that box. Ropes. Where did I throw that, that key? I think I threw it up here. Fuck. Yeah, it's all the way up there. Shit. Alright, Oh crap, where's the chest? It's probably behind the shopkeeper. I'm not gonna blow that up for the chest. I'll just keep the key. Maybe you can do a key run and go all the way to the and beat Olmec with the key. I mean, go to the temple with the key and unlock the temple the temple shortcut. Cuz I haven't done that yet. I've only had the shortcuts for Oh, hurry. Ooh, that was close. I only had the shortcuts for the ice cave and the jungle because to unlock the one for the temple, you need to go all the way to the temple with the key. And that's kind of difficult. But hey, maybe we can do it today. Not likely, but maybe. Is it worth going down there? Nah. That'll take two bombs to get that chest, that box. How long have we been going for? We've been going for just 20 minutes-ish. That's fine. I can do that. This video, I planned on this video being at least an hour long. Oh, Jesus. Alright, I'm just gonna bomb these guys. Okay. Come on, trigger. No! Oh god! That was terrifying. I didn't need to put a rope there, but I did for whatever reason. I'm not sure why. Oh boy. The jungle always makes me like so goddamn anxious and racks my nerves like crazy. This game is weirdly, besides that one thing, like, this game is weirdly calming for me. Usually when I get super... Fuck! No. Alright. As I was saying, this game is, generally, a relaxing thing for me. If I get, like, super frustrated, or anxious, or angry or something, which, you know, every now and then what I'll do is I'll just like put up a game of Spelunky and just like play it. There's something weirdly zen about this game, no matter how frustrating it can be. I think it's because, like I said earlier, of how fair it is and how like every time something screws up, it's not because the game kind of cheated you. It's just super fun. I'm not usually into really difficult games. A lot of platformers actually don't really care for because they seem weirdly difficult. But like games like Spelunky, games like Hotline Miami. Ooh, fuck. Okay. Games like Hotline Miami and this game are fantastic, and I love playing them. Speaking of Hotline Miami 2 comes out. That could have ended badly for her. Hotline Miami 2 comes out fairly soon, I think. And I definitely want to do some stuff on the site about that, because, man, Hotline Miami 1 was real good. It was a real good game. If you haven't played Hotline Miami for whatever reason, it's a couple years old now, you totally should. It is... Man, it's... Soundtrack's great, gameplay is great, art style is great. That game is fantastic. I didn't review the game, but if we had the site when that game got released and we did review it, I don't know. That might be a 5-star game. Maybe. Oh, good. Dead or restless, meaning I can get a free shotgun. But, oh, there, actually, the shotgun's right there. Alright, let's see if I can murder this fool. Nope. Alright, get my shotgun. Oh boy. This is gonna suck. No! No, no, no! God damn it! Shit. Continue. One thing I noticed is that the Vita version actually loads faster than the PS3 version of this of the game. Loading times kind of suck on this version. You know, in between levels, like the Vita version. Once I die, I shouldn't have done that. The Vita version. Once I die, I can pretty much jump into another round fairly quickly, almost instantly. I want to say. Oh, look at, there's boxes there. This game takes a little bit to load, which is, you know, it's not like, oh, it's not like Wii U loading times or anything like that. It's just a little inconvenient and makes it like the Vita version that much more. Like, I think this game is perfect for the Vita, is the thing. It's like, this game is a really quick pick up and play game, play a few rounds and then put it back down. It's not a game that I spend a ton of time with at once. So, like, playing it on a console, well, it's great to see it nice and pretty on this big screen. It's not a huge selling point, especially with the Vita, because the Vita actually has a fairly nice screen too. The colors look actually a bit nicer on the Vita than they do on the TV. That's because the Vita has an OLED display. At least the old Vita has an OLED display. The new Vita, the thinner Vita, the Vita Slim, or whatever you want to call it, has an LCD. To preserve battery life and stuff like that. Actually, no. Is it to preserve battery life? I forget. It has a smaller display. Not smaller. It has a LCD display. Which some people do not like because the colors aren't as rich. Whether that makes it more accurate or not is not something I don't know. I haven't played enough with, like, display technology information stuff. So I actually can't answer that question. Also, I haven't touched a new Vita. I still have my old school Vita. But, anyway, we don't need to talk about that stuff. It's unnecessary. No! Missed my rock. Fuck. Boom, 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 boom. Die! Fucking god, I kept getting stuck on that stupid ledge. Go there. Hit the rock. Move. What else? You. There was nothing here worth getting, was there? Nope. 500 gold. I guess 500 gold is something, but... Man, I can get 500 gold any day. Oh, God. So many spiders. I apparently killed something. Ah! No! Shit! That was a... stupid thing for me to do. Alright, this is our last one. If you don't get very far in this, then that's kind of it for our test. Let's see. Alrighty. Oh, fucking god. This run's already gonna go bad. I can feel it already. Oh, it's gonna be the worst one. Kinda just wanna kill myself now and just end it. Alright. What's up? What's up? What's up? What's up? Alrighty. That's good. I'll take you. Oof. Spikes. I could have. Always look. Oh! That's unfortunate. Oh, I need something to. All right, I'm gonna get this pot here. So, Well, I was gonna say before I got scared to death by that trap is always look down before you drop into the next section, because there can be things like that, like those spike traps or those tiki or those arrow shooters. I can't buy anything here that's worth getting. Like, I don't really care for the mystery boxes. And don't die. Ooh, God. I was running away from that arrow like a madman. Jesus, that was a risk I probably shouldn't have taken. I could have activated that tiki trap by just that arrow trap by just throwing down a rope, but no, I decided to outrun it because I'm a moron. Ruby. Sawed off. Oh. I'll take some of this. Take some of that. I'll get that gold too. This guy is stuck, so he won't. Oh no. Alright. Let's see. Oh, he's dead. Haha. Oof. Oh, okay. Let's turn around. Boxes. Get down. Oh, look at all that gold over there too. And a key. Let's take the key. I think I saw the chest by the damsel. Not sure though. Yep, there it is. Come here, pretty lady. Oh, fuck. Run! Damn it. Alright. Let's get you. Let's get you. I hate the climbing gloves, so I'm not gonna get those. Oh, God. Fuck. Alright. We're done. We're dying in the next one. I know it. I can feel it. I'm gonna do something stupid, and we're gonna die in 1-3. And we never made it to the goddamn ice caves. Oh, shit. Oh, God. See, that could have ended me right there. Alright. I'll take you, I'll take you. Oh, I can't even get the boots. Now I can, I think. Okay. Let's get that ruby. Okay, nothing there. I hear the lady. Is she around here somewhere? No. Alright. Okay, so we didn't die here. We're actually at the jungle now, but like I said, the jungle is the worst, so I'll likely die here real fast. There's the lady. Take her, because I need her to heal up. Ah! Alright, I'm just trying to concentrate here and not die. Okay. I'll come back for that boomerang. No! No! Oh, Jesus. Okay. Woo! And our health's back up too. We're back up to 3 health now, so maybe... Oh, god damn it. Alright, I'm getting rid of that boomerang because I need this. Land there safely. Alright, Don't get in the water. Some bunch of tiki traps. What's over here? Oh no! No! Alright. We're done. That's it for, I don't know, Spelunky Sunday! We'll call this Spelunky Sunday. Because today's a Sunday and we played Spelunky. Alright. That's it. I suck at Spelunky. See you guys. Whatever. Keep your eye on the site. We'll have some stuff up in the near future. We're still putting up stuff slowly because, you know, we're still building the site, essentially. Getting people on board to cover things. Oh, I'm yawning. I'm sorry. I should not do that into the microphone. But yeah, so, it's a slow process, but we'll get there. Look out for a video about the Elgato, an at-a-glance video about the Elgato. We have some more stuff coming on the site this week, we planned. We should have some added glances to two new games that are coming out. I don't know if I want to say them. Yeah, sure. Persona 4 Arena Ultimax comes out on Tuesday, so we should probably have something on that either Wednesday or Thursday. Smash comes out on Friday, so there should be something out about that on the site on Saturday, probably the day after it comes out. And then there'll be an Elgato at a glance, and I have some other things planned, maybe some at a glance and some iOS apps that I think are kind of cool, maybe some reviews in the near future. We got a bunch of stuff planned, but yeah, thanks for watching, guys. This is a test of the Elgato HD60. Hopefully everything works in the capture and nothing exploded, and the bitrate's high and it all looks good. Anyway, thanks for watching. Keep your eyes on blipmedia.com, and we'll see you guys in the near future. Bye.